It's a place where life is very, very difficult. It is subsistence here. It's to people work so that they can eat, so that they can feed their families, so that they can live. There's no real concept of trying to build anything more than that for many of the people here.
I don't think many people are aware how poor Nepal is. Certainly people that are going into the Kathmandu and into the Khumbu get a false impression just as to how poor these areas are. If you don't come into remote valleys like this, you just don't know.
People who live in Samagon, healthily, they are not, getting support from the health. Like they are very dirty. If they have a problem, some stomach or some things, they don't have get medicines. Their mind also be very old, you know. Always, if they become sick, they will call the lamas or some other peoples and reading the lama, making puja, and finish it. And they don't try to give them medicines. And slowly, the patient will die one day, definitely.
Richard and Mingma and Julian and myself, we concocted this aid project where we could supply food to this village, medical treatment and dental treatment, all at the same time as injecting money for the people, for porters, for an expedition. So by putting those things together, we've been able to do this project.
Nepal is like, there are like 80% of the Nepalese people living in the remote area. They have no access to dental treatment. And all of the dentists, 90% of the dentists are all focused or centered in the city, capital city, and they never go out here. I mean, everybody, we're all human beings. Everybody is susceptible to dental disease and dental problems. I think it's great to come up here and help the people and introduce dentistry here, you know. It can be fixed, you know. I mean, it's all about education. We have to educate these children. So when they grow up in the next generation, I mean, these kids will have a lot of knowledge about their own dental health. We want them to look after their own dental health so that they don't suffer all the pain that their parents went through.
Okay, I'm done.
First of all, I think that SmileHigh has been able to get a lot of people out of pain. That's important. I think that coming to a place like this, which, you know, the people might almost feel as though they're a little forgotten in the world, and to have people come and work with such enthusiasm to try and help the people here, I think that has been a real boost to the people in this village. I mean, I think that the idea of having, say, SmileHigh coming with a Nepalese team, Serena, Pasang and Mingma, and for them to, for Serena and Pasang to be able to deliver a message to the school, and also at the same time make it clear to the children in the school that they came from remote villages in Nepal themselves, I think that really kind of is a motivation to the children here, so that they feel as though there is an opportunity for them if they do pursue education.
I just think it's been a highly successful trip, and one thing I'm really also excited about is the fact that we've coordinated SmileHigh, which is the dental component, together with medical and the UNWFP, and being able to provide food. And I love this cohesion of different disciplines getting together and coming out to a remote place. It's
we come from a land of plenty. We've never really wanted for anything. It does give you a better perspective on life and what is important. And also, I think even as dentists, you can come here and try and do something even a little bit helpful, and try and help people who are in pain.
So I think we both come back and we bring something back to where we're from, yeah, that other people can appreciate. I think this is, yeah, something about treating the world as one place instead of, yeah, treating the world as our home, your home.
Yeah.
You know, as a dentist, this is, you know, you feel like you've got so much energy to do well, as much as you can as a dentist, and you don't get a cent for it, and yet it's so much more rewarding than, you know, getting paid very well to buy your flash car, flash house, or whatever. It's just so humbling to, and it just sort of being able to give back, and you know, at the end of the day, it still does not feel like giving back much, but it's doing what a little bit that what you can. And what's really amazing is that you have had an impact on your patient's life. So getting them out of pain, or you know, just sort of helping them out with a problem, and hopefully giving them a tiny improvement on their quality of life, which is just, I can't even imagine how bad it is up here.